But you've never been one to shy away from IP, really, right?
Well, what's the IP? Men in Black?
I mean, I guess you created the IP. Yeah, or that was
That was an IP.
Unfortunate series of events.
Right, and by the way, I was fired off the feature.
Were you really? Wait, is that brought up in the book? I don't remember.
Nope.
What happened?
Well, you can ask me anything. Here's what happened. I read the books to my kid, and I loved them. And what I loved about the books is they posit that children are smart and capable, and all adults, whether they're evil or mean well, are equally ineffectual, which were my parents, right?
I was going to say, based off of reading this book, that sounds like your worldview. Yeah.
That's my parents.
Yeah.
So I loved it. And Scott Rudin, who produced The Two Addams Family, was producing the feature. And I was hired. We had Jim Carrey. And at some point, Scott quit. And I'll never know why he quit. It might be a budget thing. It might have been that he saw the writing on the wall. And the head of Paramount was a woman named Sherry Lansing, who had replaced Stanley. And Sherry said to me, honey, this movie is too expensive for dark comedy. There's never been a dark comedy that's made money. And I said, Sherry, I directed two of them for you, Addams Family and Addams Family Values. Those were dark comedies. She said, oh, they don't count. So she said, we need a partner. And I got her Sony, but she didn't like the Sony deal. I said, go to any studio you want except Amblin. Because if you go to Amblin, the producer, the head of Amblin at that time, was a husband and wife named Walter Parks and Laurie McDonald. And they were the producers of the Men in Black movies, and we didn't get along. I think that if we hadn't worked together, we'd be really good friends. He's got a great sense of humor, but we didn't get along as a team. And I said, if you go to Amblin, Walter will fire me the next day. So she went to Amblin, and the next day, my lawyer called me and said, Sherry Lansing just called me and said, you quit. And my lawyer said, I said, no, he didn't. She said, okay, he's fired. What difference does it make? So I was kicked off of the movie. Cut to, years later, Netflix buys the books because Paramount screwed it up and didn't want to do a sequel. Buys the books. And
the movie didn't turn out that great. No offense to people who worked on it, but I don't know if it did well. I don't remember.
It did okay. The problem is the filmmaker made the movie about Count Olaf, which was Jim Carrey, and I always felt the movie was about the kids. And Neil Patrick Harris is fantastic in the show, but it still is driven by the kids. So I heard Netflix was doing it, and I got my way into that meeting, and I told them exactly the way I would direct it, that Lemony should be an on-screen presence, although not present in time, but physically, visually present, even though he's telling the story from the future. Told him exactly I wanted to shoot it entirely on stage in Vancouver. And I even told the three executives where to sit so I could look at all three of them in one three-shot. And I left knowing I had the job because I was so passionate about the books. And they hired me, and we went to Vancouver. We shot it entirely on stage. And I was lucky I got fired off of the movie because it deserved 25 hours and not 2 hours.
And you may not have had the energy to make the show after having made the movie, right? They may have done it, and you mean like, I already did that. I was already in that world.
Well, the thing is, I think that if I had done it, it might have gotten a sequel. I don't know, but it might never have gone to Netflix. But as I say in the book, you can never rethink anything you do in life because there's so many trillions of decisions made by you, made by the bus driver who didn't hit you, made by the bicyclist that didn't take the left turn there that would have run you over because they're late delivering the Grubhub stuff. So no matter what happens in life, even in the, if you're going to, I'm on a plane tomorrow, even if I have to elbow sweetie and say, was I right? The plane's crashing. You can't go back.